In elections past, the seat of Lindsay, based around Penrith, was the heartland of John Howard's battlers. Now, Labor holds it by the narrowest of margins. And Scott Morrison fancies his chances of wresting it back.
It was once an iron law of Australian politics. You win the Western Sydney seat of Lindsay and you win government.
That's the one. Thank you so much.
It might not be the case in this election, but the fight is tough. And with nine people on the ballot paper, at times strange. The Christian Democrats candidate has been praying for rain through dance. Clive Palmer's man shared a video where it claims John F. Kennedy's murder and 9/11 was a conspiracy, while Fraser Anning's candidate, Brandon Lees, fancies himself as an amateur comedian.
Tell them what gender you are.
I'm a woman.
Pauline Hanson's One Nation is still campaigning in Lindsay, but interestingly, they're not running a candidate, even though they polled more than 7% of the vote at the recent state election. Labor's Emma Husser won the seat in 2016, but was forced to quit. Her replacement, a former state minister, who managed to keep her hands clean in a shambolic New South Wales Labor government.
But I had a great 16 years as a state parliamentarian. My record stands on its own. I delivered for our local area.
The Liberal Party sees Lindsay as its best chance to pick up a seat off the ALP in New South Wales. And Melissa McIntosh says the big issue is power prices.
There's older people that are wrapping themselves in blankets in winter and they can't afford to turn on the air conditioning in summer.
Bills have risen more than 100% in 10 years, six of them on the Coalition's watch.
Do they trust the Liberal Party to deliver on lower energy prices, do you think?
They want somebody that's going to be listening to them.
Through all of this noise, it's any wonder voters can hear a thing. Chris O'Keefe, Nine News.